Welcome back. Kwashevill State has joined the League of States looking inward to diversify and grow their economies through agriculture. Governor Ben Ayade's administration is introducing the kibbutz system of farming, which allows indigents to own little portions of farms with assistance from the government.
Cross River State, South Nigeria, like some other states in the country, is blessed with good soil texture for farming. The state government wants it to be easy to embrace agriculture, and that's why Governor Ben Ayade is encouraging farming amongst his citizens through the Israeli know-how system, popularly called kibbutz.
I use this opportunity once more to tell every Cross Riverian that you must own a farm. You must own a farm. If every one of us had a hectare or two. And that's why I'm introducing, as I return now, the kibbutz system, which is an Israeli system where every small person has one small farm. Government comes to you, assists you to do the harvest, pay you off, allow you to grow another. We need massive supply of corn. I am tired of trip. I have to put a team to go to South Africa and to return to Germany, where I've concluded discussions with corn farmers who will come here and introduce the new modern digital corn farming techniques.
According to Cross Riverians, farming remains the safest way out of poverty and hunger, and they're willing to push the state's agricultural sector to be the most productive in the country.
Really, this is what creates wealth. Farming creates wealth. A seed will give you up to 200 seeds.
Encouragement for the youth to really see farming as a way of life. I think if we do that, we'll be better off than not all this dependence on one source of economy.
Their hope is that the government will match its words with action, soon to enable youth begin to see farming as another way of life.
And 1 week after the Minister of Power, Works and Housing ordered the Federal Road Management Agency to begin repair work on the Asaba Onitsha Expressway, a directive is yet to be carried out. A portion of the road on the Asaba end of the expressway remains in a deplorable state, hindering smooth flow of traffic. Commuters and motorists have continued to lament the poor state of the road, where they're forced to spend hours. Channel Television has made several attempts to get the management of Fema in Delta State to speak on the cause of the delay in carrying out the work without success, as the management's staff are said not to be available. And Imo State government has launched a new tax scheme to ease intra-city movement within Owerri municipality. The move is part of efforts to fulfill Governor Okorocha's promise of giving Owerri City a facelift and creating employment opportunities. The scheme will put a stop to tricycle operations in the state. And that's it on the program News Track, News Across Nigeria. Thank you for watching. I'm Neil Taigbe.